Merry Christmas to all today. So guys, do you see all those presents behind me? Only those behind me are the one that I gave. But all of these presents are from Santa for me. And guys, the evidence that I'm giving you that Santa came is cookies gone, carrots gone, and milk gone. So that's proper proof that Santa actually came. All the other presents behind me were by other people. So today, Merry Christmas. Today is Christmas, and for that, I'm giving it to you. Sorry about that, I'm a bit cold. Today I met Santa. To Lord and Johannes for being good. Merry Christmas from Santa. The day I met Santa. Have you finished your Christmas list yet? Good mum. Jangling car keys. Hurry up, we're all... Mum was waiting to take me to see Santa today. I quickly wrote my name and address to the bottom of the list and folded it. Coming, I shouted. And guys, look at this. It says, who's flying past the window? See that? Look, it says, who's that flying past the window? Who is that? Guys, guess down in the comments below who you think it is. Okay? I pulled into the car park. I looked around for Santa's sleigh and his reindeer, but I couldn't see them. Do you think Santa's here? I asked Mum. I didn't see his sleigh in the car park. Maybe he's parked it around the back, said Mum, so that the reindeer can have some carrots in peace. We took our place in the quiet of Santa's grotto, and before long, it was my turn. I touched my Christmas list tightly and went into the grotto to meet Santa. Was magical inside the grotto. Everything sparkled, and there in a big chair was Santa, rocking his fluffy white beard.
Well, 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 I see you have a long list, laughed Santa.
I don't put everything on the list, I said, hardly. I don't want to be greedy.
Oh, if you remember to leave me a mince pie when I visit on Christmas Eve, I'll see what I can do.
I won't forget the mince pie, Santa. I promised. On Christmas Eve, I hang up my stocking and got ready for bed. As I walked past my window, I saw a tiny sled shooting through the sky. Santa's sled was on its way! What if Santa's sleigh had crashed? What if Santa had lost my list? What if Santa had got stuck in a snowstorm? What if Santa forgot to visit my house?
That's a big problem that he's thinking about.
but I don't think, I think Santa can make it. Do you? But Santa never forgets anyone. He was traveling at magical speed to thousands of worlds. Santa's sled ducked and dived. It swooped and swirled, delivering the parcels to every child on his list. From busy to city, to the smallest villages, he visited every house. Quietly, he delivered the parcels and stuffed stockings with gifts one side of town. Then he stacked the presents under the tree and dropped the packets on the oven. Santa's sleigh was on its way, and Santa remembered a gift for the elves who'd helped at his grotto. I wonder whose house Santa is visiting next.
Wait, from busy cities to the smallest villages, he visited every house. Quietly, he delivered parcels and stuffed stockings with gifts on one side of town. Then he stacked presents under the tree and dropped off packages on other. Santa's sleigh was on its way, and Santa even remembered a gift for the elves who'd help at the grotto. I wonder whose house Santa's visiting next. It's the question here. Every time I say a word, it's actually, every time I say it and you see a blue writing, that's the question that I'm asking you. So that's why you're wondering why it's not over here. I think it's the boy or maybe the girl that was worrying so much that Santa might forget about him. Finally, Santa's sleigh was on its way to the very last house. Everything was calm and quiet, except for a distant jingle and far-off jingle. With a gentle thud, Santa's sleigh landed on the rooftop. I was all tucked up in bed, snoozing soundly, and dreamed of mince pie. Suddenly, I woke with a startle and sat up in bed. I forgot to leave Santa a mince pie. I'd have to go downstairs and make sure he had one before it was too late. I padded into the kitchen and turned on the lights. I was still half asleep. Lucky Mum had helped me make some mince pies earlier, and I was pretty sure she'd have some carrots too. And guys, now it's the blue reading of the. That broom behind the door looks familiar. Who do you think this guy is? Do you think it's Santa? Or just somebody dressed like Santa? Sure enough, the mince pies were on a plate on the kitchen worktop, and there were plenty of carrots in the fridge. Who's that
sneaking out of the kitchen. Look at that. Nobody would be dressed up with that kind of thing. So it has to be Santa. Must be. Quietly, I carried the carrots into the lounge and left them by the fireplace. I fetched the mince pies and put them by the Christmas tree. Shh, Kitty, don't wake Mum. Whose feet are those peeking out from the curtain? His mince pie. I was so glad I had remembered. I was lucky I woke up before Santa came. Oh, oh, oh! Before I climbed into bed, I gazed out of the starry night. I do hope Santa's sleigh is on its way. At long last, it was Christmas morning. I bound downstairs. Mom, Santa's been. Who ate all the mince pies? That's Santa probably. And that's the end of the day I met Santa. And guys, in part two of this video, in the previous video, part two, I am going to tell you what was inside each of my presents. Okay, guys? So, bye, guys. See you next time. And Merry Christmas.